What was revealed during the Jerry Sandusky case is horrifying, but a CNN.com commentary raises a thought-provoking question. Should pedophiles be extended some measure of sympathy? Are we doing enough to identify and help pedophiles before they victimize our children? Dr. James Cantor wrote that commentary. He is a psychologist and a senior scientist at the Center for Addiction and Mental Health in Toronto, and he joins us now. Doctor, thank you for joining us.
My pleasure.
I want to ask you something, and I know people are going to probably send me a lot of hate mail for this. I've never been one to take glee in anyone's demise, and when I saw Jerry Sandusky walk out in handcuffs, I did kind of feel a bit sorry for him, even though I know the jury found him to do some horrific things. I was like, you know, his life is over. All of these young boys, it was terrible for them as well. There are no winners. In your piece, you say someone has no choice to be a pedophile, but someone can choose to not be a child molester. So explain that to us.
Well, we have to understand very specifically that pedophilia is separate from child molestation. Pedophilia refers to the actual, genuine, underlying sexual interest. For some reason, and we haven't worked out the details yet, there are some people born with a genuine sexual interest in children. They didn't ask for that. Nobody asks to be a pedophile. That just seems to be the case for these people. But that's very different from child molestation, which is a choice. They can't control what they're attracted to, but they can control what they do with those attractions.
So someone was born that way and they can't help themselves, but that's not to make an excuse for their behavior.
Exactly. I mean, they're not responsible for what they're attracted to. They appear to be born with it. We know through a series of brain studies, both from my research group and from other teams, that they're born with slightly different brain anatomy. Mm. And the differences that they show are not the kinds of differences that emerge over a lifetime. Rather, they seem to be the kinds of differences where whatever the chain of events it is, that chain of events began before birth. It really had nothing to do with any choice that they made.